Hello everyone, welcome to a special session on EDC preparation strategy for GATE 2022. I welcome you all again. Just a second, I'll just see whether the class is on or not. Just a second, wait for a minute. Just a second, yeah. So, welcome to Unacademy, India's largest online learning platform. So, today we'll be going to discuss about EDC preparation strategy for GATE 2022, right? So, GATE 2021 has done. So, we have seen some good number of problems in GATE 2022 EC paper, and now we will be discussing about how EDC subject should be prepared for GATE 2022, right? So good evening you all, welcome to this special class. So myself Shravan Kumar, I have master's degree from J2H in VLSC system design. I have 10 plus years of teaching experience. I can handle subject like EDC, analog electronics, digital electronics and EMFT. I have a special code for all you guys, which will be useful for you to get 10% discount on it. 10% discount on plus subscription. So the plus subscription will have a benefits of live classes, crash courses, weekly tests, doubt solving sessions, English and Hindi, and you'll be having something called rank improvement batch. These are the benefits of plus subscription, and you have iconic subscription. Along with the benefits of plus subscription, you'll be given a personal coach, a study planner, a study booster sessions, a personalized test analysis, and then a preparatory study material will be there. And if you look at the fee structure, after 10% discount for 12 months, it is going to be 27,225 rupees. For 18 months, it is going to be 34,650 rupees. For 24 months, it is going to be 13,600 rupees. This is about plus subscription. For iconic subscription, for 12 months, it is going to be 45,225 rupees. For 24 months, it is going to be 66,600 rupees. Okay. Yeah, I'll leave this here. So now the important thing here is the most important part of EDC preparation is going to be, first of all, we need to know what is the syllabus. What is syllabus? If you know syllabus very well, immediately, immediately you'll understand what to do and what not to do, right? So if you look at here, these are the seven areas where your preparation should be there, right? The entire syllabus consists of, sir, at the end of this class, I'm going to teach you a seven-step strategy for EDC preparation. So please listen to me till the end. And share with your friends. So let's see how many people will come and join for the session. Okay. So these are the seven parts which will be most important categories of GATE syllabus. That is semiconductor physics, PN junction diode, BJT, MOS capacitor, MOSFET, special diodes and IC fabrication. These are the seven parts of the EDC syllabus. So this knowledge is sufficient even for ESC, engineering service examination also, right? EDC subject, Joseph, the basic concepts are very must even for a EE students also. Especially the PN junction diode overview of the subject is very much important even for a EEE student also, Joseph. So don't miss this sessions also, right? So semiconductor physics, PN junction diode, bipolar junction transistor, BJT, MOS capacitor, MOSFET, special diodes and IC fabrication, here are the different parts of the syllabus, right? So if you look at the semiconductor physics, So why I know why you know most of you already know about the syllabus, but I know why I'm trying to discuss is I'm trying to explain you the how many hours of preparation is required. you know the syllabus. Simply, you can download the syllabus from the GATE website. Probably every year one institute will conduct the GATE. This time IIT Bombay conducted the GATE exam. So next year another institute will conduct the GATE examination, right? It is not just about knowing the concepts or the titles of the subject. You must be able to discriminate what topics you should omit, what topics you should not read for GATE examination also you should know. Right? That is the reason why I am telling you at the end, I am going to tell you the 7-step strategy for GATE examination. 7-step strategy for GATE examination I am going to tell you. Okay? Right here. So, for the first part is going to be energy banks. So, this is very, very important for a semiconductor physics part. Sir, if you look at all these concepts like diffusion current, drift current, mobility, resistivity, Poisson's and continuity equation, carrier transport, equilibrium carrier concentration. So in EDC syllabus, frankly speaking, the first two parts of the ED syllabus plays a major role. That is semiconductor physics and then the PN junction diode. If you are comfortable with the semiconductor physics, even in 2021, if you see, the three questions were asked from the same concept of semiconductor physics. Same kind of semiconductor physics only, they have asked. And frankly speaking, they have not asked some questions from some part of the syllabus. So, my humble request is concentrate more on this topic called semiconductor physics. At least you should, sir, if you are preparing on your own, like, you know, if you are attending all my online classes and then studying, self-study you are doing, not joining in any other institution, At least you should have concentrate of 20 to 25 hours. 20 to 25 hours is required for the semiconductor physics. Complete knowledge of semiconductor physics. For complete knowledge of semiconductor physics, minimum of 20 to 25 minutes, 20 to 25 hours is required. Right? I'll tell you what textbooks you need to follow and what are the steps to be followed to gain strong knowledge in the fundamentals of semiconductor physics. So these are the topics which I am going to cover in sequence. Sir, you should remember EDC is an independent subject which doesn't require any prerequisites. You don't need to have any knowledge. If you look at analog electronics, the subject which I am teaching, you should have a knowledge of this EDC and as well as networks. Because you should know KVL, KCL. Most of the time, our discussion in analog electronics will be with KCL, KVL, and diode, transistor, MOSFET. So for that, you should definitely have the knowledge of EDC as well as networks. But EDC is a subject which doesn't require any basic knowledge. We can start from the scratch without having any knowledge also. And I am here to teach you from the scratch. Today, from 6 to 7 p.m., the first class of EDC will be going to start. So, please do join that for that session also. Okay. So, these are the topics so which will be required at least 20 to 25 hours of solid preparation to become the master of the subject, the semiconductor physics. Okay. Then the second part is going to be PN junction diode. In the PN junction diode, we'll start actually, first of all, I'll explain you what is a PN junction diode. Why a diode is called diode. Our journey starts from why, what, how. We'll question everything, right? Why a diode is called diode? What do you mean by open circuited PN junction diode? The energy band diagrams. Current components in PN junction diode. Sir, this topic is a very important topic. Diode current equation. If you guys know the diode current equation, most of the time questions will be based on this diode current equation. Most of the time the questions will be based on this diode current equation, right? So anyway, ideal versus diode, ideal versus practical volt ampere characteristics, all these things will be there. But most of the time, this ID, the diode current equation, is very, very important for you. direct current equation is very, very important for you. And the temperature dependency and transition. So this is also very important. Transition diffusion, diffusion capacitance of a diode is also a very important concept to be remembered. This is also a very important concept, right? So for this also, at least you should spend 15 to 20 hours minimum. 15 to 20 hours, 15 to 20 hours of time is required to master the subject of PN junction diode. To master the subject of PN junction diode. Okay. So you are requested to concentrate on this part also. First part is semiconductor physics. Second part is going to be PN junction diode. Okay. Then the third part is BJT. So if you are comfortable with the diode, you can easily understand what is BJT. You can easily understand the BJT, that is principle of operation. If you understand the working principle of a diode, so it is just like you're adding back-to-back connection of two diodes may become a BJT. It is construction-wise, not operation-wise, but construction-wise, back-to-back connection of this thing, diodes is going to be that. And you will be having a common emitter, common base, common collector. Sir, here we'll restrict our discussion only for configurations. We will not get into in detail of this biasing of by BJT. Biasing of BJT will comes under analog electronics. So in analog electronics, we'll discuss about the biasing of the BJT. First of all, we'll discuss why a BJT is called BJT. Why a transistor is called transistor. Our discussion starts from there. Our discussion starts from there. Okay, so the BJT is BJT, and I think at least 8 to 10 hours is sufficient, more than sufficient for BJT. 8 to 10 hours is more than sufficient for BJT. Okay, then, sir, this MOS capacitor, sir, many institutions will not teach about this MOS capacitor, but the MOS capacitor is a foundation for MOSFET. MOS capacitor is a foundation for MOSFET. So you guys definitely should know, should have a good knowledge of. Good knowledge of this MOS capacitor. If you understand the concept of MOS capacitor very well, then the MOSFET is very easy. MOSFET, I would say at least 7 to 8 hours minimum you need to spend on the MOS capacitor, including problems. 7 to 8 hours. 7 to 8 hours. So you'll understand what is accumulation, what is depletion, what is inversion, all these things. You'll understand what you mean by a flat band. So threshold condition, threshold voltage, all these things you'll understand from the concept of MOS capacitor. MOS stands for metal oxide semiconductor capacitor. So this requires at least 7 to 8 hours of preparation, right? Then here comes the important story. Sir, nowadays, the complete shift happened towards FET, sir, MOSFET, especially MOSFET. If you look at the question paper of 2020, 21 and 2020, so the questions which are asked on the BJT is actually, frankly speaking, the complete BJT is removed from the syllabus. I mean to say, in the question paper of analog electronics, even in EDC. But the questions, more questions were asked based on MOSFET. Generally, the institutions will not focus much on MOSFET. But nowadays, the concept of MOSFET is very, very, very important. In that, we'll be definitely discussing about JFET and MOSFET. JFET and MOSFET. For this also, if you are good at the MOS capacitor, you need just 12 to 15 hours of MOSFET preparation. MOSFET preparation. 12 to 15 hours of MOSFET preparation is sufficient. Out of it, you will cover JFET and MOSFET. JFET and MOSFET. Right? So focus on this also. Then special diode. This, especially Gina diode will be asked, some questions will be based on this Gina diode. You should understand the Gina diode. Remaining all the solar cell, very rarely asked, very few times asked these questions based on LED, photodiode, solar diode, solar cell and pin diode. But regularly they'll ask questions on Gina diode, either in analog electronics or in digital electronics. So I think 5 to 6 hours of preparation is sufficient for this special diodes. 5 to 6 hours of preparation is sufficient for this. Sir, if you want to still spend a lot of time, you can spend at least 10 to 15 hours. It all depends on how much time you want to give. How much time you want to give. Okay, this is a special diodes concept. And then here comes something called IC fabrication. IC fabrication. So diffusion, oxidation, ion implementation, photolithography. I think 5 hours is more than sufficient for IC fabrication. Sir, some students will not study this IC fabrication, but I would suggest you to spend just anyway when you are doing for 1 year long preparation, don't miss this also IC fabrication concept. This is actually useful for advanced electronics concept from engineering service examination. Okay, so please focus on this. Now, the textbooks which are which will follow here is the electronic devices and circuits by Milman Halkalkes. We call this as a black pad actually. Black pad. Some people will also use yellow pad. So this is the yellow pad which generally people will also use. This is also having integrated electronics. This is called integrated electronics. Okay. So that book also can be used. Solid State Statement is another beautiful book you should have. Definitely from the concept of electronic devices, the Milman and the Statement is also okay. If you want to practice more number of problems, you can use this Semiconductor Physics and Device by Donald A. Neumann. And then Boylestad also a very good book. And for the concepts of CMOS and other concepts, so this last book is a very important, right? The Principles of CMOS PLS are designed by Neil H. E. West and Cameron H. Gim. Okay, this book was also very important for a CMOS VLSI system design. So I would suggest at least you get one or two books. That is more than sufficient. Don't buy all the books. You'll be confused about this. Once you're studying my material, my classes, if you follow and practice questions from any other textbooks, that is sufficient. Now, the important concept of the day is, this is the very important slide for me. That is, I call this as Saptapadi. What do you mean by the Saptapadi? The Saptapadi means, Sapta means seven, Padi means the step. The seven steps which you need to follow for the best preparation of EDC subject is, first learn the subject. How to learn the subject, sir? You can listen to the classes, online classes. You can listen to all the online classes and read the textbook. This is a very important step, sir. First step. Step one is learn the subject, right? Even you are scratch, even if you are zero, even if you had a backlog of EDC when you are studying engineering, nothing wrong in it, sir. Right? But start learning from YouTube classes or textbooks. Step one is learn the subject. Start reading the subject. Once you start reading the subject, and then prepare your own notes. Sir, this is very important, sir. I'm telling you, this plays a major role, right? Simply listening to the classes will not give you 100%, sir. We don't give you, actually any faculty, even the author of the book will not give you 100% of the subject, sir. You will learn only 50% from ours, our classes, our text and everything. A faculty can give you 50% of help, but next 50% is in your hands. So for that, what you do, sir, you prepare your own notes. This plays a major role, right? So prepare your own notes. Prepare your own notes to understand, to remember all the concepts. This is very must, sir. Then practice previous year questions at least 10 to 15 years. I mean to say from 2005 to, I don't want me to practice from 1992. Okay, from 1992 means all are basically concept based questions, but the level of gate examination is changed from last 2007, 2008. From that, the levels of the difficulty of gate exam is increased. So definitely, after learning the subject, after writing your own notes, start practicing questions from the previous year papers. That is 10 to 15 years old papers you need to practice, so that you'll understand where to concentrate more and where not to concentrate more. Sir, if you are done with this all these previous year questions, then, sir, Sir, whenever I ask you to practice previous year questions, just don't copy question and answer. Understand the questions. Right? So there will be some important concept in the question itself. So when you get some wrong answers, it shows that there is something wrong in your understanding of the subject. Don't simply practicing previous year questions is not a great thing, sir. So you should look back why your answer is wrong. Do the analysis on each question of previous year gate. So practice previous year questions means don't just practice. For each and every question which you practice, you check whether your concepts are correct or not. If your concepts are wrong, then you correct them. Yes, Vijay Kumar. Yes, BJT questions are not asked. So practice your previous year questions. Practice your previous year questions is very, very important. Okay. Practicing of previous year questions is very, very important. Then if after completing the previous year questions, go to solved problems from the textbook. I'm not asking you to do exercise questions. First, try to solve the problems which are solved problems, which already they have some answers. After that, if you want, you can go for exercise problems. Practice as many number of problems as possible from the textbook of the exercises. Right? First practice solved problems from the textbook. Okay. After these four steps, almost 70% of your preparation is done. 70% of your preparation is done. Once your 70% of preparation is done, then it comes the short notes, sir. So here you have prepared notes, right? From that you start preparing a short notes and formula summary. This is very important, sir. Preparing formula summary is very, very important. The short notes is very, very important, right? So in the second step, you have prepared your own notes, but you make a short notes like this. I'll show you. See, even as a faculty, I am preparing my own short notes. I'm preparing my own short notes like this. Just 4 or 5 pages. 4 or 5 pages short notes. And similarly, when we can see the solutions of PYQs, for what? Surya, what is your question? What your question means? When we can see means, are you asking me? So I have already done 2011 previous year questions. You can see them. Okay. Then after these 5 steps, this 6th step plays a major role, sir. Keep revising the concepts of the subject and go for subject-wise mock test. Sir, so if you are a student of college going, at least spend 2 hours or 2 to 3 hours minimum on some subject preparation. Minimum 2 to 3 hours of subject preparation is required every day. If you start preparing for 2 to 3 hours, in 1 month, in 20 days actually, 20 to 25 days, in 20 to 25 days, Surya, you are saying if you are not getting the answer means it recommended to see solution. See, before seeing the solution, you revisit the question, right? There might be some misunderstanding by you in the question. Any student who reads textbook, any student who listens to the class will definitely have 70 to 80% of the understanding of the question, right? When he goes back and reads the question second time, he will understand that there is some misunderstanding by you itself. Try to answer this for second time. If you are failed to do second time also, then you can go and refer the solution. then you can go and refer the solution. Okay, Surya. Okay, then go for subject wise mock test, sir. So in 1 month from, if you are preparing only 3 hours a day, in 1 month you will become the master of the subject if you are seriously preparing 3 hours a day, sir. Plan accordingly, just like 2 hours of preparation, 1 hour of notes, 2 hours of preparation, one hour of notes. So probably in 2 hours of preparation, one of notes, probably in 20 days, you will finish everything and you keep revising the concepts. Sir, this 1, 2, 3, 4 will be, let's say you are starting your preparation today. So till probably I would suggest for any subject I'm talking about, for any subject, let's say till June, July, this should be finished. June and July, this should be finished. From August and September, this short notes preparation formula summary should be ready. And then you should start your revising. You should start your revision at least weekly once. You should revise your concept, this notes, short notes. Short notes and formula revision should happen once in a fortnight for every 15 days. For every 15 days, definitely you should prepare your short, read your short notes. So this should happen in September and October. From November, every week you should revise your formulas. In December and January, every day you revise your formulas. Don't go for subject-wise mock tests in the end. So in August and September, you should go for subject-wise mock test. Subject-wise mock test, topic-wise mock test, topic-wise and the subject-wise mock test. So will be, you should finish it before August and September. From October, you should start subject-wise tests, and then from November onwards, November, December, January, dedicate for full-length tests or 2 subject tests, 3 subject tests. Then full-length test you should write from the November month itself. Probably weekly once in the November, weekly twice in the December, weekly thrice in the every alternate day you should write in the January, right? So before 1 week of 10 days of the gate examination, this is not requested to do any tests. So only revision should happen. Okay, this is what Saptapadi, this is the 7 steps which you should follow to become the master of the subject of EDC, right? So if you have any doubts, keep posting in the comments so that I can reply you. Okay. Yes, Pawan, the course definitely starts from the basics. You can see, you can attend from 6 to 7 today. From 6 o'clock, you can attend this session. From 6 o'clock, definitely I'll teach from the basics, Mr. Pawan. Right? Obviously, my aim is to teach the student who is below average. Not somebody who is already having some knowledge. Okay, Pawan. Yeah, that's all for today. So we have something called Plus Subscription. Plus Subscription will have live classes, crash courses, weekly tests, doubt solving sessions, English and Hindi subject will be taught in English and Hindi. And we have something called Rank Improvement Batch. So this is the Plus Subscription. We'll be having something called Iconic Subscription. Iconic Subscription is nothing but we'll be given a personal coach, a study planner, study booster sessions, personal test analysis, and preparatory study material will be there. Preparatory study material will be there. Okay, then. The fee structure for Plus Subscription is 27,225 rupees. For 18 months, it is going to be 34,650 rupees. For 24 months, it is 13,600 rupees after applying a code SVS10. After applying a code SVS10, okay? Then for Iconic Subscription, for 12 months, it is going to be 45,225 rupees. For 24 months, it is going to be 6,600 rupees. Right? So all my class notes will be available on a Telegram channel of Unacademy Gate English. Telegram channel, sorry. On this Telegram channel, you can find my class notes. Yeah, the basics of this subject is required, Surya. Basics of the subject is required for even an ESE student also. Okay. So, we have different YouTube channels. Createx Gate, EE, Unacademy Gate for mechanical engineers, instrumentation, production engineers, and engineering sciences. An academy, civil engineers and chemical engineers we have. Unacademy Computer Science and IT, Unacademy Gate Questions, separate Gate Questions to this, Electrical Engineering. I am teaching on Unacademy Gate English, so which will help you a lot. So please do join on this. So I request you to subscribe the channel, like the class, and share the class so that many students will be getting benefit out of it. And then hit the bell icon so that Raviteja class will be from 6 to 7 in the evening. Raviteja, today also class will start from 6 to 7. You can attend today's class, Raviteja. Okay, right. Thank you. We'll catch up at 6 o'clock.